Oh. and me. But pretty Almondine, bright as the sky, I idolize. And I'm going back today to that maid so far away. Oh, how I miss her. I long to kiss her. Oh, how we'll cuddle. Every night he'll do our spooning underneath the Japanese moon. Wedding bells will chime in old Japan, and then we'll plan to have a merry time in Tokyo, where soft wine flows. My chrysanthemum, I love her song, my yum, yum, yum. I can close my eyes and see, waiting there so patiently. Oh, how I miss her. I long to kiss her. Oh, how we'll cuddle. Every night till you are spooning underneath the Japanese moon. Thank you.
mimicry, imitations of the human voice. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, spoken by a little boy. Mary had a little lamb, spoken by a little girl. Domestic scene in the morning. Mirage! Time to get up. Yes, Mama, I'm coming in a minute. Imitation of the Scotch bagpipe. Bird song, the Bob White. Whippoorwill. Chickadee. Canary. Imitation of a church organ.
lives in Burgundy. She's all the world to me. Though far away, both night and day, she's always near to me. My sweetheart young and fair, my heart is with you there. When shadows fall, I hear you call. Where is my love? Oh, where?
When is my phantom in Burgundy? I want to be with you.
Want to be with you.
In that great old town of Burgundy. With you, dear, with you.
Just to be with you.
Just to stroll along. Just to hear you talk. Just to love you long. Just to love you strong. When it's night I'm down in Burgundy, I want to be with you.
Down where the roses grow, down where the waters flow, down by the mill, I see you still, as in the long ago. The rose will die someday, the waters flow away, for you, Marie, and Burgundy. My love will live forever.
When it's night time come in Burgundy, I want to be with you.
Want to be with you.
In that quaint old town of Burgundy, with you, dear, with you.
Want to be with you.
Just to stroll along. Just to hear your song,
Lord.
Just to love you long,
Lord.
Just to love you strong. When it's night time comes in Burgundy, I want to be with you.
Down in Burgundy, I want to be a couple too, doing just as you and I. Leaving, grieving, never even say goodbye. We'll see boys and girls from coast to coast with the ones they love the most. Meet me down in Panama, and no matter where we are, so we crawl and go astray. Like the children do, we'll meet halfway down in sunny Panama. Life is sunny too, where the oceans meet in Panama. That's where I'll meet you.
Such lakes and dells. No wonder that the angels love the shamrock for the shore. Tis a little bit of heaven, and I love it more and more. Sure, a little bit of heaven fell from out of the sky one day, and nestled on the ocean, in a spot so far away. And when the angels found it, sure it looked so sweet and fair. They said, suppose we leave it, for it looks so peaceful there. So they sprinkled it with stardust, just to make the shamrock grow. Is the only place you'll find them, no matter where you go. Then they dotted it with silver to make it look so grand. And when they had it finished, sure they called it a
thank you. Thank you. you do? You'll pardon me, but I don't know you. Don't be surprised, you'll recognize. You're no detective, no, I'm just surmise.
What?
You're from the place where I long to be. Your smiling face says the same to me. You're from my own land, that sunny homeland. Tell me, can it be? Are you from Dixie?
Yes, I'm from Dixie.
Where the fields of cotton beckon to me.
I'm glad to see you.
Tell me, how be you?
Well, just look me over and see.
Are you from Alabama, Tennessee, or Carolina?
Well, I was born below the Mason-Dixon line.
And you're from Dixie. Hooray for Dixie! 'Cause I'm from Dixie, too.
Was away back in 89, I crossed the old Mason-Dixon line. Gee, but I've yearned, long to return to all the good old pals I left behind.
My home is way down in Alabama, on a plantation near Birmingham. And one thing certain, I'm surely flirting with those southbound trains that run to Dixie,
to dear old Dixie, where the fields of cotton beckon to me. I'm glad to see you.
Tell me how be you and the friends I'm longing to see. Way down in Alabama,
Tennessee, and Carolina,
or any place below the Mason-Dixon line.
So you're from Dixie. Hooray for Dixie! 'Cause I'm from Dixie, too. anybody could be. As he made these remarks in his sweet melody, he wobbled with pride from his nest in the brush and said that the spring was just made for the thrush. The robin and wren kindly asked him to hush. The pretty blue jay. I think, Mr. Thrush, you are wrong when you say
we know that for all was made beautiful spring. Our warbles and trills we together should sing.
The thrush quite agreed, so they made the woods ring.
Says the old brown thrush with glee. Says the robin too from his nest in the apple tree. And the lark and quail from the top fence rail. And the chorus from the shady lane. With his day's work done came the farmer's merry son, who was loudly whistling this refrain.
Thank you.
Thank you. don't like this job of taking the census. If I'm in it much longer, I lose me senses, and that's all there's about it. I have corns on me feet from walking around, and corns on me knuckles from knocking on the door. Well, I'll try this place here, then I'll aim in the job. That's all there's about that. Look at the face on this coming to the door. There's a face for you. The map of Ireland.
Well?
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 Well, well, what do you want? What do you want? What do you...
I don't lose your excitement. I'm taking the census.
If you take anything here, I'll have you arrested.
Look here. You'll answer the questions I prescribe for you, or I'll have you pinch.
Pinch? Pinch? Why?
For breaches of the census, I'm a limb of the law.
You're a what?
A limb of the law.
What's that?
I don't know what it is, but I'm it anyhow. Answer the question. What's your name?
Desdemona Mulcahy.
Desdemona Mulcahy. Hmm. How old are you?
I was.
Never mind how old you was. How old are you now?
I've seen about 24 summers.
You've seen them?
Yes.
How long were you blind?
I was never blind.
Shut up, shut up, shut up. Are you married or sensible?
I married.
Has your husband?
Yes.
Is he living?
Yes.
What for?
What?
What's he living for?
I don't know.
Well, does he work for a living?
He do.
He do.
He do.
Who does he do?
What?
Who does he work?
What?
Where does he work?
In a bank.
Oh, he works in a bank.
He's a director.
He's a director. What does he direct?
Envelope.
Is that your face?
What?
Is that your own face you have on your...
What do you mean by talking to me like...
Shut up, shut up, shut up. Have you made any donations to the matrimonial fruit basket?
What?
Have you made any donations to the matrimonial fruit basket? Have you any kids?
Kids?
Children.
Oh, yes, I have five. Almost.
Never mind, almost. You have five now that you know of. You sure of?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. What are they? Boys or girls?
Well, there's three boys and there's three girls.
Well, sure, that's six.
Well, one of them is twins.
That's the finest joke I heard for days. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. What's the color of them?
What?
What's the color of them?
How dare you insult an honest married woman? What's the color of them? What do you think the color of them is? Do you think I married a nigger? Get out of this. I'll slam it on your face. Get out of it. Get out of it.
There's me door slammed in my face. No luck again. Oh, I'm sick of this job.
Hey, say, what's the matter, Casey? You look pale.
I just had a fight with Oney Gagin.
What, little Oney Gagin?
Little, but he's not small, that man. I had hard work to lick him.
How did you do it, Mike?
I tell you how I did it. You see, Gagin and I, we've always been the best of friends together.
Yes.
Now we're enemies apart.
Oh.
Well, you see, Gagin and I, we went down on the wharf to fish...
In the water?
To fish in the water.
For fish?
Sure, for fish in the water, for sea. Not for beef, steak, and onions. Well, you see, I was fishing in the water for the fish, and I wanted to cut me fish line a little longer because it was too short, and I felt in me pocket, and I found me knife.
Wow!
Gone out of me pocket.
Wow.
I had me suspicions aroused immediately towards me sporting companion sitting beside me.
Gagin.
So says I, Gagin, says I. I looked him straight in the eyeball. Says I, you have me knife. You're another, says he.
Says he?
Yes, says he, says I.
did you?
No, says he.
Oh, wow, wow, wow.
Go there yourself, says I.
Says he?
No, says I.
Oh!
You're another, says he. And says I, your grandmother was no gentleman, and I told him things. I told him things. And I lost my temper.
You lost your temper?
Yes, and I lost my knife at the same time. That's two things I lost.
Oh!
I could find neither of them. So, says I, Gagin, I'm going to give the undertaker a job.
Did you?
Aha! And I made a rush at him. And I put my finger in his mouth.
Did you?
Aha! I did that. And I wouldn't let go.
Wouldn't you?
I couldn't. Aha! Then I got up off of the floor and I made another rush at him. And I gave him a bump in the face with my face.
With your face?
Well, something happened anyhow, and I got up again off of the floor and I made the third rush at him. And I gave him three or four bumps, and I, as luck would have it, I fell down again and I got up again. And then says I, now I think of a thing and I'll tire him out. I used a bit of diplomacy. And you know what I did?
What did you do?
I started to run. I run around the place, and he asked me.
He asked you.
And I run around again, and he asked me.
He asked you.
And I run around again, and you know, I felt him behind me puffing, you know, and getting tired out. And then I'd run about a half a mile. I turn around on him, and I wipe the floor up with him, you know.
Did you?
When I see him again, I'll kill him.
Will you?
I'll kill him when I see him again. And not have him insulting me and stealing me knife.
Here he is coming round the corner.
I don't want to see the man. I've got to have no trouble. Come on, let's go away.
Wait a minute.
No. Come on. Come on, let's go away.
Wait a minute.
No.
Constable, Constable, you know that's a fine tune. What's the name of it?
That's Christian's Awake, sir.
Christian's Awake? By golly, that's funny. My name is Cohen. Say, Constable, can you tell me maybe perhaps where I can find it, the telephone? I want to call myself up a number.
Yes, sir. Just step in that cabinet, sir.
Oh, in here. I see the idea. Yes, all right, I'm here. I want 4614 City.
4614 City? Mm. Number engaged, shall I call you?
No, thank you. I'll stay here. I'll call you. Gimme, please, for something, 4614 City.
No smoking in the cabinet, please.
Shut up. Get away from here. I ain't smoking.
No smoking in the cabinet, please.
I'm not smoking. What are you trying to do? Find out who I'm calling up or what? Hey, wait a minute. Hey, here, give him sixpence. Go away.
I said no smoking in the cabinet.
Yes,
please.
Yes, and I'm not smoking.
I didn't say you were. Are you calling?
Yes, I'm calling, miss. I want 4614 City.
4614 City?
Yes, please, miss.
4614 City?
Thank you, please.
4614 City?
Oh, it's a pretty little number, isn't it?
4614 City?
You'll soon know that blooming number by heart, ain't it?
4614 City.
Well, now we're all agreed.
Put the tuppence in the box, please.
All right.
Well?
Yes, pretty well. How are you?
I'm waiting for you to put the tuppence in.
But I just put the money in.
Please don't argue. Put the tuppence in the box and turn the handle to the right.
To the right. Another tuppence. All right.
Put the other penny in, please.
I just put it. Say, what do you think I am, the Bank of England or something?
I'm not here to argue with you. Will you put the other penny in, please?
Oh, all right. What's the use? Now then.
Certainly, old chap. Yes, hello. As I was saying, what does it matter if it does cost a bob or two more?
I'm not putting any more money in.
It isn't a question of money, is it?
Yes, it is. I put already nearly a shilling in, counting the band.
I say, who the deuce are you?
Maybe I'm the war office. You want to have a fight or something, too?
Or get off the line, nosy.
Or get off the line yourself. Hey.
He Is your line working all right, sir?
Oh, yes, it's working fine. It sounds like a menagerie. Do you know you give me the wrong number?
What number did you say you wanted?
I want 4614 City. And hurry up, miss. They ain't expected to live long.
Did I hear you say you wanted 4614 City?
Well, I don't know whether you heard me say it, but I'm sure everybody around here for miles knows what number I want.
Well, I'm sorry, sir, but that number is disconnected.
Oh, and the same to you and many of them.
Hello. Hello, Central. Say, Central, for the 50th time I'm asking you, will you give me, please, 10090 City? What? They're busy. Well, they're lucky. They try them again. Maybe business got dull again, eh? Hello. Oh, hello, hello, hello. Is that the health department? I say, are you the health department? Yes. For the health. What? Oh, I didn't tell you to go no place. No, sir. I said, for the health. What? I should speak more distinctly. Well, I'll write it down for you if you like. For the piece of wood. With a B and the H-E-L-L-C. Health. Now, are you the Board of Health? Well, my name is Sam Cohen of Plotkin and Cohen. I want you to send me down a doctor to my place to pick up the office boy. What? What's the matter with him? Well, he just followed a half a dollar on us. I say the office boy just followed a half a dollar on us. Followed it. Eat it. Yes. A half a dollar. Cash. I want you to send down a doctor. A doctor, yes, not a lawyer. We don't want to sue him for the money. You know, before we get judgment against him, the boy might die of stomach trouble. So I want you to send down a doctor. What do you say? If the boy's followed a half a dollar, it wouldn't do him no harm. Well, it ain't drawing no interest there, is it? So I want you to send down a doctor to look the boy over. What do you say? Give him hot water with mustard? All right. I did give him mustard. Nearly a hatful. And that's enough mustard to invest for a half a dollar. No, he didn't come across with a penny even. What? You'll tickle his throat with a feather? Listen, Mr. Health Department, this is no tickling matter. Something terrible might happen to that boy before he digests so much money. So I want you should send down a doctor. What? I should get a doctor for the boy? Listen, Mr. Health Department, I don't need your advice in the matter. I should pay a whole dollar to a doctor to take out a half a dollar for my boy. By golly, you got a great head for business, Mr. Health Department. I don't think. Besides, why should I get a doctor at my expense? You know, he's an office boy, not a relation. I'll send him down to you. Say, and whatever you get out of the boy, you can keep. Come on, be a sport. Take a chance. Maybe the boy swallowed other money on us that he ain't missed yet. Maybe it's a habit with him to swallow money. What? How do I know he followed money? Well, I don't know. He ain't exactly a cash register. He don't ring a bell every time he takes in money. But whatever is in him, you are welcome to. I don't care if it's diamonds even. What do you say? The boy needs a safe blower, not a doctor. That's enough, Mr. Health Department. I don't need money so bad as all that. I wouldn't injure that boy for the sake of a half a dollar. Money ain't everything with me, Mr. Health Department. I got a heart. So I'll try him with another hatful of mustard, and if he don't give up that half a dollar, I'll stop it out of his wages. I'll teach that young loafer a lesson. Goodbye. Good health, Mr. Health Department.
Love light in your eyes will ever shine dim. in the orchard way down in my heart.
Won't you come back to me? Bring back the sunshine that you took away with you.
All the world seems dreary without you, dearie. I am lonely for you only.
Down in the land of cotton, you're not forgotten. The springtime is calling for you. We will love each other like dad and mother. Come back, dixie, dixie, do.
Again we wander through the wild wood, where the orient was thronged with magnolias all day long.
Your face is mirrored in the silent river, and the brook seems to ripple your song.
Down in my heart, a memory starts with recollections of that old affection.
My dreaming seems to bring me consolation.
And someday every dream will come true.
Won't you come back, Dixie? Bring back the sunshine that you took away with you.
All the world seems dreary without you, dearie. I am lonely for you only.
Down in the land of cotton, you're not forgotten. The springtime is calling.
my window in a peaceful reverie, resting from the worries of the day. A sweet voice singer sang a quaint old-fashioned melody that brought me dreams of Ireland far away. You dreamed you were a child on mother's knee. Yes, I seem to hear the song she sang to me. Dear old Irish songs my mother sang to me, songs of queens and goblins in the wild wood. Sweet old Irish tunes that haunt my memory, they bring me dreams of my childhood.
My childhood.
How I love those songs of old, sweet songs of love so quaintly told. Oh, believe me, if all those endearing young songs, my heart throbs to that old melody. Oh, Jip, Jip, me little heart, Jip, Jip again, sir. How many miles to Dublin town? 3 score and 10, sir.
Was on a bright morning in summer that I first heard his voice speaking low.
Did you ever see a feather? Did you ever see a feather? Did you ever see a feather on a tomcat tail? Did you ever see a feather on a tomcat tail?
So dear old-fashioned Irish song, my mother sang to me.
The one about the real estate. Do you remember that one?
I don't think I know that one.
Don't you remember, Charlie? You asked me, do I know anything about real estate? And then I tell you that I know all about real estate. And then you say to me, what do you know about real estate? And then I tell a joke. Now, are you ready now, Charlie? Now, did you know that I know all about real estate, Charlie?
No, I hadn't heard it. And it's a great surprise to me, too.
Say, Frank, I was thinking
that... Yes. Charlie, don't start thinking in this thing. If you do, we'll never get this joke on this thing. Now, start it all over again. Now, Charlie, did you know that I know... That I know all about real estate, Charlie?
No. What do you know about real estate?
And then the answer is when I come right back at you and say, oh, lot. See the joke? Oh, lot. You thought I was going to say I couldn't really state. Well, that's the end. That's all I got to do. Go on with the music, Charlie.
How are you?
I'm all right, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine.
It don't make no difference how you are, Charlie. Start the joke after I'm all right. We'll never get this thing on this record if we gotta wait and find out how you are. What do you think we ought to play on the bagpipes, Charlie?
Why, play anything you like.
Well, I tell you what we'll do. We'll play what I played when I was over in England. How would that be?
Well, I didn't know you were in England, Frank.
Oh, yes, Charlie. I was over there when you was over there. Don't you remember?
I didn't know you came across.
Oh, yeah. Well, what do you mean, Charlie, I don't come across?
I come across.
You're the guy that never comes across. I was over in England. I was on the stage over in England, Charlie.
How did your act go over there?
Well, Charlie, they thought I was an intermission over in England. When I came out to do me act, everybody would go out in the bar. My main joke didn't seem to go. You know the joke, Charlie, where I say to you, why is an old maid like a frozen tomato?
Yes.
Well, over in England, I said to the leader, you know, the joke is, Charlie, why is an old maid like a frozen tomato? And then the leader's supposed to say, I don't know, why is an old maid like a frozen tomato? And then the answer is, because it's hard tomatoes. That's the joke, the way it's supposed to be. But over in England, it didn't go. I put it over, and it lay there, it did. Now, I said to the leader, why is an old maid like a frozen tomato? See? And the leader, he said to me, I don't know. Why is an old maid like a frozen tomato? Like that, tomato. That ain't funny that way, you know, Charlie. I couldn't finish it then. I couldn't say it's hard tomato. No, I didn't have no joke when that guy got through with me. I didn't over there. And another thing, Charlie, I did have a fine automobile I used to drive around over in England.
Is that so? What make car was it?
Well, I ain't supposed to mention no certain car, don't you see, Charlie? Over in the show, I get paid for mentioning the Briscoe. But the Briscoe people don't pay me anything to advertise the Briscoe automobile in here. So that's why I'm not going to mention the Briscoe in here, don't you see? It's awful funny over in England, Charlie. Another thing, when anybody bumps into you over there, they never say excuse me over in England. Over there, they don't.
No, what do they say?
Well, they just say, I'm sorry, like that. That's cute, ain't it? I'm sorry. I got so when they'd bump into me, I'd beat them to it. I'd say, you're sorry ahead of them. Well, listen, Charlie, what do you think we ought to play on the bagpipe?
Why, play anything you like, Frank.
Well, I tell you what to do, Charlie. You get them guys with you to start something, and then I'll jump on while you're going. You understand?
All right, go ahead, boys.
Thank you.
I sing a lee, sing a low, that means I want to go to Tokyo.